the old adage is that playing the bad guy is always the flashiest part in the movies. But the godsend in this particular movie is that I've lived through three Saws. If I get to live through another one, I'll be lucky. But being the bad guy gives you a lot of freedom to be devious, mischievous, and all that kind of stuff. Eric's character has been watching everybody since he arrived on the scene, you know, as far as a couple of movies ago. He's a veteran cop who knows his stuff, and everybody should be aware about it because he's not stupid. And basically, he teams up with a few people, including my character, and they go off chasing, you know, the ghosts of the past. I know one thing about the Saw fans, that they're really clever, they're really into it, and if they feel let down, they'll turn. And so far, they've stuck with it, and they've been quite happy. And it's hard to maintain, you know, after two and three and then four and then five, it's hard to maintain that high standard, I think, for a lot of franchises. But so far, so good. And I don't think they're going to be let down with this one either. Look, it's hard to top a lot of traps that they've already done. But you see the traps on paper and you think, wow, how are they going to pull this off? And then you see them in the movie. And a lot of times they're better on film than they are on the page. So, you know, I don't know where they come up with the ideas. I know that they're still as shocking and as powerful as they were at the beginning. And in this one, guaranteed, there's some really wild stuff going on. But we have a little mini genius that's doing this called Kevin. And Kevin, he's doing a great job, and he knows these movies inside out because he was the editor for most of them, or all of them. So as far as all different personalities, but all have the same hunger, you know, and we're having a ball. Well, if you ask people, I'd say they think I'm the goofiest actor in the world, because in between, I tend to make a lot of people laugh, and I need to have a laugh with them, and they give it right back to me, which makes the day go faster. But one time I remember saying, when I was first here, I said, yeah, would you like me to be more of a serious actor? Because this is too funny. We're having too many laughs. And they said, no. So they approve. But I know one thing, when we actually see the movies, when they're done, you don't get a feeling that people were laughing too much at the set. Twists and turns as usual. Some really horrific traps. And a couple of big surprises, you know, and I think this movie, if they don't have the big surprises, where it's in the middle, towards the end or the end, it loses a little bit of its zap, but they've always managed to have pretty good endings, or actually very good endings. And this one's going to be... It's funny, you know, that for the first three movies, I never knew the endings. They wouldn't give me the last pages. But this particular time, they gave me the ending, and it's a pretty effed up ending.